America, home of the free. Well, unless you decide that you want to go surfing, then you get a $1,000 fine. And I live in Southern California. I know this is New York, but it's the same thing. They're handing out, it's like cotton candy. Everyone, you want a $1,000 fine? Because I'm sure the corona is out in those waters, man. When I paddle out by myself, ooh, the risk that I am inflicting on America. So in this video, you're going to see the frustrated side of me. Because, you know, I like America and I like the freedoms that are given, our founding fathers gave us in this little pesky document called the Bill of Rights, where you have freedom of movement. And I'm also dropping some big names like Ray Dalio, John Stossel. I got some beef. And why does the stock market keep going up? And I told you in my last video, you pump $2.5 trillion. It needs to go somewhere. Also, a bear squeeze a-happening. And I think people equate, like, stock market is going up. So everything must be going good. No, look at the bread lines. They're, like, miles long. And can we talk about the nails in the coffins of American businesses? And I'm talking shopping malls, even though there's probably not a... Dudes, right? This channel's basically dudes. Three chicks and... 98. I think this channel is about 95% dudes. Do you go shopping at the shopping mall? Probably not. Maybe your wife shops for you, but those stores will be a closing and also office spaces. What? But I'm sure WeWork will be just fine. They're going to be perfectly fine. Welcome back to my channel if you are new. If you're like under, let's say, a week old, you do not need to subscribe. But if you're above a month or, you know, a few years, consider subscribing. I make videos every single day right now. I've been pumping them out. I'm a high school business teacher, so I got some time to film some videos, make you laugh. And then all I ask is one thing. If I can make you laugh one time, because that's nice, right? You click the like button, even though my like button never works. Sometimes I have to keep clicking it. But right now I want to tell you about the stock market. Just because the stock market goes in that direction does not mean we are okay. There is a lot of stuff going on behind the scenes. And I know that's what people look for. They're like, oh, the stock market was up today. We had one of the worst days on record when it comes to the virus of people passing away. And what's the market do? It goes up. Bread lines, longer. What's the market do? It goes up. Do not put all of your hopes and dreams and eggs in a basket. I know we're approaching the bunny day, but don't do it. You need to know how to trade the market. Don't get caught just because you see it going up. I've traded my whole life. And if you were on the side of like trading crypto, you know how to get caught with your pants down. So for me, as a trader, I do not hodl it. Don't do it. I trade it. I trade momentum swings. I mean, look at this news. 5 million more unemployment claims expected. But now, okay, here's the good news. Layoffs are broader, more, and could be more permanent. Guys, the bubble, poop. And it's what follows later. And claims for unemployment benefits last week are expected to total about 5.2 million, bringing the number of Americans filing to more than 15 million. But that's not what I so much care about, is this right here. It's long-term and it's permanent. Economy has focused so heavily on the jobs that are leaving right now. We're talking restaurants and service industry. These are going bye-bye. And this is for March in California, and I feel it in California. That's us right there. We're only, you know, up between 298% and 990%. But thank goodness the cops on the beach still have a job. Is it just me, or should we not be handing out tickets like this? You know, me working law enforcement, one of the many reasons why I left working law enforcement was because I just couldn't do it. And I would, you know, pull someone over and they're like, well, or, you know, I'd call in up late and they're like, well, you're going to write it? You're going to let them go? I'm like, I'm pretty much just going to let them go. It's sad when you got to go back to the truck and the only thing that you caught for the day was a ticket. So welcome to America, land of the free, where you also, when you're done surfing,
among other things, this new order prohibits public and private gatherings of any size and requires all persons to wear coverings over their faces. This is a valid order and enforceable by fine, imprisonment, or both.
Now, think of this for a second. Because I don't wear a mask, I can receive a fine of $1,000. Not just that. After I paddle back in, they're like, oh, you don't got a mask. Here's $1,000. I could go to jail. Now, I just want to preface this by saying I'm not negating the virus in any way, shape, or form. What I am negating is a police state. What I am talking about is government control. TSA, oh, it'll only be a few days. Then you'll just be able to go right to your plane. Welfare programs, things like that. Once governments get going, they don't stop. And I don't know if you caught it, but in all of the stories that I was looking at, you know, where the sheriffs come out and they have their microphone and they're like, we're going to issue fines and citations for everyone not wearing a mask. And they're not wearing a mask. It's like when you're driving your vehicle and you look over and the cop's looking at you and he's like, and you're like, hey, you got to get off your phone, buddy. He's like, official business. And if you currently work law enforcement, no beef, man. Not throwing no shade. I used to write tickets, work law enforcement, so I get it. Now, onto the breadlines. These things are happening all over the place. And I want to know, why does this guy that's, I don't know, you caught that? You're like, dang, that's a nice car, bro. You sure? And if you were to stand in a line, well, not really stand in, if you were to drive in a line that is that long for, I don't know, how long? An hour? Like, you are financially hurting. This is not good times. Which here is our jobless claims so far, which this line above my hair is gonna get even bigger. And to even like go back to like, look at like the worst of times, the red bars that you guys see, these things are recessions. This was like, ooh, it's really bad. Oh, it's really bad. And the stock market just continues to vault higher even though everyone's unemployed. I mean, we're beating the Great Depression. We got the same effect, same breadlines, same everything's bad. So I want you to be very careful when it comes to the stock market. And just in the last week, they've seen a 600% increase. I don't know, man. Like these lines, this is not good sauce. And you know what I think this guy's thinking right here? Is now a good time to buy Microsoft or should I wait? And I think what you are currently seeing is just a bear squeeze with sellers, and they're going to have to cover their positions. And as stated by Nomura, this unenthusiastic, no enthusiasm. And that's exactly what Morgan Stanley says right here, which found that virtually no one is participating in this current bear market. But we seem to pop back into a little bull territory over the last couple days in organic bear market rally. Let's look to April 22nd. As the day of reckoning, I think markets are closed tomorrow. We get some time off. Although I think you're going to see after hours trading up a little bit, but we'll have to see on Monday. But right now, let's play the game. What did Bill just draw on his screen? See, I see a surfer dude. Right, this guy's just hang loose, chilling, waiting for his $1,000 didn't wear a mask or went in the water ticket. And now he's going to jail. But that'll just take way too long to draw, so don't even ask. Now, something I've never done on this channel was talk about John Stossel, bankrupting America. And I couldn't agree with him more, but I have some problems. Problem number one, the bill includes $25 million for congressional salaries. Whew, thank goodness Congress is taken care of. Although I am excited that for once, both Republicans and Democrats agreed. The Senate voted 96-0. The House didn't even bother with a formal vote. And like what I've been saying before, I don't care what team you root for. You can be for the Donald, you can be for the Hill, you can do whatever, you can be the Bernie. Bernie's out, and that's what they say, that the market crept a little higher today. But when it comes to a problem, whether you're left-wing or right-wing, I sit right on top of the bird. I'm not left, I'm not right, because I think it's the bird that's the problem. It's the wings. It's what's connected to this whole system. They don't care. Republican, Democrat, spend money. Go into far further debt. Now, I wanted to go over some of John's options. There are really three options. You can raise taxes, which I would be okay with that as long as that other stuff doesn't happen, print money and default. And the truth is, how will we pay off our debt? You don't. It's a Keynesian economy. You don't pay off the debt. You continue to do these three things. Raise taxes, print money, and then at some point, you default. But I think the master plan, I could be wrong, but I'm guessing it has something to do with these guys. And they are right above these guys. So the IMF can actually print money out of thin air, comes to nowhere, just poof. The Fed can almost do that. But I think that's end game. And when I look at stories and I read people and what they write, it's like they don't get it. When you print this, this is debt. Everything, the only thing that's really not debt is like this. But the way the system is, all of these digits, they all come from bonds. And from bonds, which is debt, it's an IOU to be paid back. They can print currency. This is currency. This is not money. And they can put digits into your account. But there is no hope. What he's saying just isn't accurate. Raising taxes on rich people, that's like 0%. He says it often kills the jobs. Yeah, it could. Then he says some on the left now say, don't worry about debt, just print money. What do you mean, some on the left? All on the left, all on the right. Just print money, just go into more debt. And then he says the more, he's talking about Zimbabwe, the more they printed, the more, you have a thing called inflation. But what you guys need to understand is that in these markets, when these digits enter the system, it just depends on what system. Which system wants the inflation? Now, when the government throws out digits into the banks end up buying stocks or corporate buybacks. They buy their own stocks. And then you have inflation, but the inflation is in the stock market, in the housing market. It's not in the real economy, which you guys live in. And then just like all politicians, Reagan says we must act. Bill Clinton says we got to deal with it. Obama, it's irresponsible. Trump doubles it. And then in the end, Stossel says, this is not going to end well. And so far, the deficit spending hasn't done enormous harm, but it will. You can only stretch a rubber band so far until it breaks. Our debt will wreck our children's lives. And yes, that is why I teach children. That's why I'm a teacher and I tell them, you have three options. Option number one, start a business. And that's why I leave a link in the description, three codes, whoever grabs them. I teach people how to start business on Amazon. Usually they're gone pretty fast, but there's two courses for $197. What a steal of a deal, normally $1,300. But that's my first, that's what you do. You start a business. I'm gonna indent a little bit. Option number two, buy assets. Teach your children about assets. And then they don't have to worry so much about how this is not going to end well. And number three is trade equities. Learn how to swing trade. Learn how to trade stocks in such a way that you take your business that you created, and from the business, you make moolah. Okay? And then that moolah, you can buy assets, which will protect you against inflation. And then also with that moolah, you can trade equities. And you could teach your kids that this isn't money, but this is. And then everyone gets confused. They're like, wait, that's not money? No, I do that with my high school class. I have gold and silver. I mean, you could probably make a lot of money if you just walked in and like grabbed it off the desk. None of them have a clue. And every single kid will always say that this is money. And the gold and silver, they don't know what it's worth. They're like, oh, I don't know, the gold, a dollar. And I'll tell them, okay, what do you want? You want this $20 or do you want this right here? Everyone will take the currency. And some of you guys are thinking like, man, I wish I had a teacher like you. Well, you can come on campus. You just probably get arrested. And if this wasn't writing on the walls, we're talking WeWork. They're skipping their rent payments. Man, like a multi-billion dollar company all the way down to just a little bit of thousands. But people aren't going into offices anymore. You don't want to go there. You want to work from home. You want to Zoom. You want to Skype. Who needs offices? Just be glad you don't have a building with a lot of office spaces. And for some of you that are like, I don't know, you fell off the turnip truck and you're like, what is WeWork? It's basically they were taking places that weren't rented out and renting them out. And then you get to work in these places with everyone else. They're like, oh, hey, and you can kind of go all over the place. They almost had an IPO, but nope. And this was more so of a story in 2019, the WeWork fiasco of 2019 explained in 30 seconds. And they had a $47 billion valuation. And in August 14th, they filed its IPO paperwork. And then in November, they lay off 2,400 employees. But you still get to wear 6 shirts. But officially, as of now, WeWork has no hope. Man, after this, uh-uh. Now on to more bigger fish to fry, like this behind me. Shopping malls. What is going to become of them? And everyone's like pouring into the stock. They're like, yeah, this is, we're buying the bottom. Guys, they may never come back. These stores, you may never, it's online. And that's why I sell online. That's why I have, you know, Amazon courses, is because that's where everything's going. Or like, oh, I see YouTubers. Like I bought, you know, cruise ships at these amazing low prices. Yeah, you want to know when I'm ever going to go on a cruise ship ever again? Never. And if you've ever been on a cruise ship, I'll just tell you, it's real exciting at first. You're like, oh my gosh, all I can eat food and drinks and all of the walkers that are around me. And it starts getting really bad after about, I think, the third day. After day 3, you're like, all of this food tastes the same. I just want to go home and eat normal food. But I believe the mindset is changing when it comes to business. So be very careful. Office spaces, no more. Malls. Now, when I say malls, no more, I mean, living in Los Angeles, you have places like The Grove. They have activities. There's things that you can do. It's not just shopping. You could just walk around all day long on your cell phone. Like, you don't even need anything. Or like Americana, where it's almost like Vegas, just without the gambling. I mean, you have parks, and you have water features, and you have dining. And although the dining does get a little expensive, so be careful. And you have Santa shows up, and a Christmas tree. So I think as long as the mall has activities, I think it's safe, because people will want to go there for an experience. They want to get out of the house and just walk around. And last but not least, I wanted to do a little Ray Dalio roast. Cash is trash. I almost did a video on it, and I'm just like, man, I don't know. And right about when he was saying cash is trash, I started moving everything into cash. And this poor guy can never catch a break. He had puts on Tesla when Tesla's going up. I mean, this guy is like short it and it goes up. But I know you guys, a lot of people in my audience are big Ray fans. So please be nice. But you have to remember, Ray was not nice to me. He called me stupid. He actually called me pretty, but he called me pretty stupid. If you're holding cash, like me, you're going to feel pretty stupid. And I have to say, I don't feel pretty stupid. And if you've made it this far and I made you laugh one time, just a giggle, just something, lighten the mood, would you just consider like hitting that like? And if you made it to the very end, which you did, congratulations. I want to send you something. No, I don't have anything to send you. I can't. I'd send you a hug, but they'd give me a ticket. But I make videos every single day right now. So I'll see you, what, tomorrow?